Kelly and I met several years ago now, but I can't remember just exactly what the circumstances were, but I think since we both were, you know, in the martial arts, and we just kind of had a chance to meet one day, and I was mesmerized with him, of course, because he's like a fighting machine, you know. but he's a man of great character, you know, and I admire people like that.
Oh, I was utterly impressed. Yes, I remember when I first saw him was at one of the local tournaments here, and I think I remember him doing a staff form, and he was so dynamic, so powerful, so graceful and progressive in his own ways, not totally traditional. He was very progressive even back then, and I was just utterly impressed. And so we just kind of met and became friends for almost 30 years now.
I've known about Kelly for years. He's been in so many magazine articles. He's been all over the magazines for years and years and years. So I've always known about him one way or another. When I first got assigned to Fort Lewis, Washington in 2002, the first thing I did before I even had a house to live in was to call Kelly and find out where his classes were, because I knew that I wanted to train with him.
That in. That's it. Always protect yourself at all times, because he's the kind of guy.
So I looked him up, sent him an email. He sent me a couple videotapes and a travel wrench. And then I called him on the phone. And the instant I talked to him on the phone, I knew Kelly was somebody I wanted to train with, because he's real.
After seeing Mr. Warden move for the first time, I knew that there was another person that had a lot more to offer, and I really started to follow him. So led me up until this point. You know, I can't remember a couple of camps now, I guess, four or five, maybe, I don't even know. But 10 years worth of NSI training, I guess.
I thought at that point I'd been training, you know, 18 years in martial arts. I got some sort of skill, some sort of something, but nothing. When he came out, he had the Billy Bob teeth in, and he just was totally non-traditional, totally crazy off the wall. But what really got me about the system was his flow and his ability to translate it from traditional arts and to put the stick in your hand. You go, oh, okay, well, that's a downward foot block. You put a staff in your hand, oh, okay, well, that's a downward foot block. That makes sense.
Work your center line here. At any point in time, all you're doing is releasing. There's going to be your strip anyway. Punch comes through and pack. You're right here, or you go right into your lock, you know? So, bottom line, Singleton Wally, we're moving, and you're closing on that right into the interior. You decide you don't want to do anything, there's the hit, there's the trap, there's the lock, there's the catch, there's the lock again. So it's all going to come into that. If I close here, it's right here. I'm still right there. He strikes again, I'm still right here anyway. He punches through, I'm already there anyway. So you kind of look at where it is you're going, what it is you want to do. Bottom line is you want to close, just close. You're here, that's already trapped, that's already a fulcrum, that's already released. That's already a trap and that's a hit.
When I saw Datu Kelly's information in his website, I felt that besides having this stick fighting, he had real experience as far as military training. I thought that would, you know, what better than somebody who has that real fighting experience?
NSI's kind of reestablished my passion for martial arts again. You know, you kind of get to that stage where it's like, have I touched everything? Have I done everything? And the Japanese have a term called shoshin, which basically means beginner's mind. And I think that's what Datu's kind of reinstilled in me, is like there's that love and passion there, so.
NSI, interesting. Years ago, when I first started teaching on my own, I had a studio with Sugar Ray Seals. I called it United Karate Systems, because we'd already traveled so many different variables as far as different martial arts systems. Isshin-Ryu is one of my base systems. Yaoman Nomad under Ed Lewis, who was a high-level Isshin-Ryu practitioner. Earl Squalls, Gojo-Ryu, Gojo-Kai out of Chicago. And we had done Chunin Wei. Some people know who Keith Hirabayashi is, but Keith is now a movie star, Keith Cook. But his teacher was Roger Tung. So we had integrated a lot of different elements, Filipino martial arts back then. That was in the 70s. As things evolved, it got to be to where I really wasn't karate. So Dr. Yip and I, Dr. Wai Po Yip, is a good friend of mine out of Hong Kong, and we were discussing. He goes, well, what is it you do? I goes, well, it's natural, and your spirit has to change. You know, if you're defending just yourself, you're going to have one level of spirit. If you're defending your family, that's going to be another level of spirit. If there's weapons involved, depending on your environment, everything is based off of what's natural, what's functional. If you're injured, something else is going to be added to the equation as far as your limitations or the level of intent that you're going to have to accelerate to address those issues. So natural spirit is specifically that. It's an integration of all different martial arts that I've trained in.